Father, let's talk about the BBL. How likely do you think this will succeed this time? You heard what Vice Chairman Gasari Jaafar mentioned. He said they include certain improvements, right?
Yes. First and foremost, I believe that I would like to congratulate the members of the BTC under the leadership of my friend Vice Chair Jaafar Gadsali, because they really work hard and they delivered. They delivered their assignment on time before the opening of Congress in July. So that's the first thing. The second is that, yes, they work on the original BBL submitted to the Office of the President, and the Office of the President submitted to Congress. Mm. That is their working draft. This time around, they tried to be as consultative as possible, and they really conducted the various consultations, listened to people, and I think they tried to improve it. But the first challenge that the government has to face is to reconcile this new draft of BBL. Anyway, it will be submitted to the Office of the President. And then the MNLF track, because they're also submitting to the Office of the President the amendatory law to Republic Act 9054. Yeah. So the first challenge for government is to be able to reconcile the two drafts into one proposed legislation to Congress. And hopefully this time, with this reconciled proposed legislation, Congress will be able to act properly and appropriately.
But you have two separate peace tracks there. I think the Noor Miswari faction is still very much not happy with the way the peace agreement in 1976 and in 1996 turned out, because of certain unimplemented provisions, they say. So if you are the government...
Yes. Yeah. There are 42 provisions that are identified and agreed by Philippine government and the MNLF, 42 points, but there is a consensus that that will be included in the new amendatory law. But the problem, that is not the problem. So they are willing to fully implement the 1996 final peace agreement. But the challenge now is to reconcile. I think it is possible within that realm of possibility to reconcile that amendatory law to be submitted by the MNLF to the Office of the President. And the BTC is submitting the draft, the new draft of the BBL of Bangsamoro Basic Law, to reconcile these two proposals into one proposed legislation to Congress. But of course, I suppose Congress will repeat itself, that the first thing it will do will be to create a committee both in the Senate and in the House. My counsel is not simply repeat, you see, but the danger is to be repeat ourselves. Do not repeat, you see, because by constantly repeating and expecting different result, according to Einstein, that is stupidity. So I hope this time around, the Senate, as well as the Congress, will take seriously the proposed draft. Okay. And see, if there is really unconstitutional provisions yet remaining, then they can really come up and trace it out with the principals, with the BTC, as well as with that special committee with the MNLF. Okay. I believe that the two fronts are reasonable, because all of us, Republic of the Philippines, the MNLF, and the MILF, would like to come up with a modicum of solution, sort of a transition law before the change of the charter anyway, okay. Because the president would like to go to federalism, that the full, perhaps, implementations of the two agreements will come at the end when we change our constitution. When we move from this unitary to federal, and there'll be more powers in the states, emerging states, you see, in the federal system. And that